Okay, guys, I have started with the wires. So this is for both packs. I'm just going to solder all the ends on all at once and get that mess done with. And that, but I'm only using one group. So I didn't end up having any red 10 gauge, so I had to use red 8 gauge. So no big deal. It's just overrated. All right, so I thought I would do a little explanation of what I'm doing here. And yeah, this nickel strip, damn shit is sharp. It'll bite you, so be careful if you're playing with that. Ouch. That's what this is, right? So for this, I wanted a nice, clean, easy to solder connection. And if you've ever done anything with 8 gauge or 10 gauge wire, you know soldering that is going to be hell. Right, it takes a lot of heat. This is a 3D printed part, right? Like, I don't want to melt it. So I came up with a tidy solution, and it's right here, and that's what I'm going to show you. So this is for the 10 gauge. I have 8 gauge Erics as well. So all I did was cut it to fit. This is the Eric connector, 10 gauge. You know, they could be crimped, but I always solder them. I mean, you could solder it and crimp it, but I think soldering is pretty good, to be honest with you. And if it's rated properly, your wires aren't going to heat, your solder is not going to melt, yada, yada, yada. So, because these Erics are so long, I know I have Kapton tape there, but if anything ever happened, I mean, that's a dead short across those two cells, right? That's 370 amps about to fly, you know. So you want to have something there. So I cut the Eric back. I cut it back to here, you know, to the end, to the ring there. Get rid of that. And this is what I ended up with. And I put a nice heavy-duty heat shrink on there. That gives it some extra protection. The insulation actually stops right there at the Eric. So if I was really concerned, I could double that heat shrink up just at the where the Eric is, because it's still within a possible point of issue there. Now that would have to take a major impact to move that, because it's way inside the brick here. Like, it'd have to be smashed from the bottom up or the top down to be able to damage that, and then it's got to go through the heat shrink and that Kapton tape. And there's two layers of Kapton there, so yeah, you know, I'll put another shrink on it, I guess, just to be safe. And which it's not a big deal, because it's only 3 volts or 2.8. It's not, if my positive and negative were here and it was the entire pack across there, then yeah, that's a real big deal, because that's 15 kilowatts. And that is just not a good practice. So this is the solution I came up with, and I just wanted to share that with everyone. This way I can take and solder that on real easy. It doesn't take much. Now, if you've never done an Anderson connector before, all I do, these are the heat shrinks I'm using. Just you know, get a whole bunch of them, so that goes on there, and it ends up like that, right? Out of the pack, done deal. So the Erics, I usually throw them in a C-clamp. I use a blowtorch, because you're never going to get this hot enough with a corded one. So you want to use a butane torch. And the same with the Andersons, which I don't even know if I got any of the, yeah, there's the connectors here. They're done the exact same way. You basically throw that in here. It's all a pain in the ass with one hand, but I think you get the idea, right? If you don't know how to do an Anderson, just go look it up. So you throw that in there, you heat the shit out of it, pop your solder in. So for this is like a 10 gauge. I'll probably fill it half full of solder. If it was an 8 gauge, I'd maybe go a third of the way or a little less, and you're golden, right? And then these don't get heat shrinked, because they slip right inside the Anderson and lock, right? So they're golden. I left these leads long enough that they go, there's plenty of length on them, and they go in and around and fold. They're gonna get bound together inside, And but for that reason, I can take it apart and still be able to work on it, have the ability to pop these Andersons out if I'm going to change something or do whatever I want. And the same with the balance leads, which I took out of here for right now because I'm not working on that. I'm going to do the big bulk, then I'll do the balance, then I'll join the two pieces. And yeah, so that's about it, guys. So that's what I'm doing. That's minimum rating. I could have got away with 12 gauge, but I don't want to stress 12 gauge, 41 amps at 12 gauge if I want 50 amps. It will work, but for less heat, better, blah, 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 blah. That's the best you get. All right, guys, have a great day.